Hi, and welcome in another episode of Cloud in 5 Minutes. Today, I want to show you how you could extract automatically any files from a zip without code. Aussi, si vous préférez, j'ai une version en français de ce vidéo. Cliquez juste ici, dans le coin en haut à droite. Frank Boucher, Microsoft Azure MVP, based in Montreal, Canada. If it's the first time that you join Cloud in 5 Minutes, I just want to let you know that every week I share with you little video to answer challenges in the cloud computing. Recently, in an integration project, I needed to play with files. Of course, when we play with files and we move them to a place to another, we most of the time compress them, zip them. But then, at destination, we need to unzip it. Today, I want to show you a quick and easy way to unzip it without any code. Let's get started. Like I was saying, it's very frequent to play with files in an integration project. In today's demo, I will use Blob Storage, but it's good to know that that solution will work perfectly with any file system like Dropbox, OneDrive, Google Drive, even FTP that is frequently used in integration. And also, I will use a Logic app. But first, let's go in the Azure portal and go in our storage. So here I have my storage and I will create two containers. So I'll click on it and I will go in Blob Storage. We'll create one container where I will drop my files and another container that will be there where I will have the unzipped version of it. So let's create the first container and I will call it zipped. And we'll create another one called unzip. Perfect. Let's go back to my Logic app. So here we are. I will create a blank Logic app. So I want my Logic app to get triggered when a new file is added in the blob storage, in the container. So let's check for blob. It's never far. So blob storage, perfect. When a file is added. So now we're creating a connection to that blob storage. So my Logic app has access. So we'll give it a name and then we'll pick the one I want. It was cloud in 5 minutes. Perfect. Now I need to specify which container I want to look. So in our case, it's the zipped one. Perfect. Now I want to unzip or extract package, so I will just search for zip. And like I was telling you, you will have this option in many different ones, but the one we need today is here, extract archive file. So the path will come from the context of our trigger. So if I click here, I should have the path somewhere exactly what we are looking for. And now I want to have that in unzip, and I would like to have a subfolder with the name of the file. So if I do this, have the dash, and then the name, the problem here is since the file is called, for example, test1.zip, then the folder name will be, the subfolder name, sorry, will look exactly like that. It will be test1.zip. I don't really want that. So what we could do is split it and keep only the first part. Let me show you. And just to make it clear, I will use a variable, but you could use it directly in this field. So just to make it clear, let's create a variable. So we'll add an action here and I will add a variable. And we'll initialize a variable. So let's call it folder name. It will be a string and the value is, like I was saying, we want to split. So we'll use an expression. We have split. So we'll create this, whoops, split. The value that we want to split in the context was the name. So we'll use that one here, the name. And then we'll split it, of course, by the dot. But now split is returning an array of value, and I don't want an array, I want the first value. So exactly what that we will use, we'll use another expression called first. So there it is. Okay, so I have it here just in a text file so I could show you. So like I was saying, we're using the split to cut the trigger body name as it's the file name, and we split it by using the dot. So it will give us an array with two value, test one and zip. So we'll use first to extract the first part of that array, meaning test one. So this solution should return test one. Perfect, and now we'll use it here again in our path. So we'll put here and then folder name that is our variable. Perfect. We'll use override just in case we are doing multiple time. And now just to be sure that it's done, we'll delete the zip version. So let's add another step. And we'll go for a blob storage again. And I'm looking for delete this time. So delete blob. And of course, I will use path. I just need to be, so this is extract from archive folder. This is this guy. We want the trigger one. So here, when a blob, this is my trigger. So I will use the path of that one. So path. Perfect. So now it's all done. Perfect. So now we'll set run. Cool. So now my logic app is waiting for me to drop a file. Today I will use the Storage Explorer. It's a Microsoft tool that is available. It's open source. It's free. We'll put the link down in the description of this video so you could download it. It's very useful. So here I have it in my subscription in the container. I will just refresh it. So now we see both the zip and the unzip container we created. And I will drag and drop. It worked like an FTP back in the days. So I will drop my file and will be uploaded. So zip one, test one dot zip is uploaded. So now we'll be waiting here in our solution to see when it's working. Perfect, look like it worked. Let's check here our variable, see test one. So it worked as expected. So let's double check. We'll go back. Now we'll switch to the container unzipped. And I have here a folder, test one. And if I double click on it, I should have three images that I put it there. Voila, it worked. And just like that, you could unzip any file. Obviously, you could zip it also and move them to back them up or anything. It will work like I was showing in many different scenarios. FTP will be one of the very common used. I hope you liked this video and I hope it was useful. If you want to know more about Logic App, I prepare a playlist available just here, and you have just down below another video of Cloud in 5 Minutes. Enjoy! See you next time!